Hi everyone, my name is Victor and I'm one of the authors of technique.com. Today we're going to continue with our course. We're going to look at how to manage ACL in Linux. All right. In our previous lesson, when we talked about permissions, we noticed that setting permission has focused on giving permissions only to one user, which is the owner of the file, and to one group, which is the group owner of the file. But what if you want to give permissions to more than one user or groups on a file or a directory? Or what if you want to give permission to a user that is not a member of a group? How do you achieve that? So we use ACL to achieve this. ACL is, in full terms, is access control list, all right? And with ACL, you can give permissions to more than one user or groups that are not owners of the file in Linux. So ACL is just an advanced permission mechanism in Linux. Quick one, if you're writing the RHCSA exam or the LFCX exam or the SUSE Linux examination, you can scroll down to the end of the website and come and click on the practice questions, which is the dumps of the exam you want to write. We're going to be updating the website from time to time, all right? And I'm also going to be dropping the link to the website in the description section below so that you can easily click on the link and follow through. The Linux kernel must support ACL before ACL can be used, all right? There are some old Linux kernels that doesn't support ACL, but the new Linux kernels, they all support ACL. So to verify if your kernel supports ACL option, you can use the command. So let's do this. I just want to grep for ACL. All right, so you can see ACL to be yes. So you can see ACL equals Y, ACL equals Y. All right, so that means that the ACL support, the kernel supports ACL. If you see N, which is no, then the kernel doesn't support ACL. You should also know that using ACL requires that the file system where permissions will be set is mounted with ACL options. There are some file systems that are mounted with ACL options by default, like the EXT2, EXT3, 4, BRT, FS, and ETC. Those file systems are mounted with ACL options. But if your file system is not mounted with ACL options by default, you would need to mount the file system with ACL option before you can use ACL. And to verify if a file system is mounted with ACL option, you use the command. Let's look at the blocks we have. All right, so let's verify if the SDC is mounted with ACL option. So use the command tune2fs on SDC. I'm just going to group for default mount options. All right, so you can see that the device SDC is mounted with ACL option. If the device is not mounted with ACL option, this is how you're going to install the ACL utilities in Linux and mount the file system with ACL options, all right? So since we're using a Red Hat 8 system, and of course, most of the file systems is mounted with ACL options by default, we're not going to look at this here, but if you want to know more about this, you can just come to this website to learn about it. I'm going to be dropping the link to the website in the description section below. There are two commands that are used to manage ACL. They are the getFACL command and the setFACL command. The getFACL tool is used to get an overview of an access control list on a file. So, for example, let's get the access control list for the file. Let's do for pictures, for example. So you can see the overview of the access control list on the file pictures. And it is also possible to view the permission of a file using the getFACL command, just as you use the ls-l command. All right, the getFACL will display the file permission that is set with ch mode and the file permissions that is set with ACL. While the set FACL command is tool or command is used to set or change the access control list on the file. So in the next video, we're going to look at how to use the ACL options and how to set permissions for users, groups, and others on files and directory using ACL. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe to this channel and bye for now.